So we've got Ajax nil away at APOEL to discuss. And an Ajax who were within seconds, Brian, of getting to the final in last season's campaign. They looked like they might have a little battle on their hands to get into the group stages this time.
Well, they've got out of it 0-0. They'd be happy enough in the end, having lost the player laid on to red card and made very few opportunities, clear-cut opportunities. We didn't see any of the style that we saw last season, the magnificent football, combination play, intuition, link-ups between the midfield and the front players. Not much from the full-backs either, overlapping. It was an un-Ajax-like performance, I'd say. But you have to give the home team, APOEL Nicosia, credit for disrupting them and stopping the efficiency of the play we saw last year when they seemed to be able to get goals both home and away at will, nearly. So, you know, there'll be a worry, I think, for the coach, then Ten Hag. I think that they were so limited looking at times, but there'll also be a confidence on how they've started the season domestically, that they've scored goals at home and that they've no match at the weekend. They've got a clear week to prepare for the second leg. And I think they'll do it next week. Mm. But I don't think they would have expected it to be as awkward as it was tonight.
I guess Onana was probably man of the match, the Ajax goalkeeper, Keith, which tells you everything. But again, it's that quality that keeps them in the tie.
Yeah, very much so. And look, when you look at the domestic games they've had three competitive games, two previous qualifiers. Didn't really see this coming. You know, this is something that you might suggest would be very early stages of the season where, okay, they're caught short. Okay, some of them have come back late from international duty. He's rotated the squad in recent weeks to ensure they're all fresh. But it's all about these games. It's the gravy train. It's the financial aspects of it to keep that force going in the right direction, because they want to continue the good work. The obvious questions are the players that have left in the summer. I still think they're capable of qualifying and doing okay in the Champions League.